Hey, what's going on, everyone? Jake here with Venture Visuals, and today we are going to be breaking down how to create this super trendy bling effect in Adobe After Effects. I find that this effect works best on clips with shiny objects like jewelry, lights, or cars. I was unable to find a tutorial that explained how to do this effect in the way that I wanted it to be done. I ended up having to experiment on some of my own footage for a few hours, just trying to get this effect to look how I wanted it to. To make this effect work, we're going to be using a plugin called Sapphire Glint that's a part of the Sapphire suite. If you're unfamiliar with Sapphire plugins, it's a bundle of plugins by Boris Effects. You can check them out down below in my description. Now, at first glance, the Sapphire Glint plugin seems relatively simple. However, upon further inspection, you'll notice that there's a lot of parameters which you can change within the plugin, making this super customizable. The plugin also features its own built-in Mocha tracker, which is going to help us take things to the next level, as you'll see in this tutorial. If you're excited to add this bling effect to your bag of editing tricks, make sure to hit the like button down below and let's dive in. So here in After Effects, you can see we got a clip of this artist who's wearing this really shiny watch. Unfortunately, it doesn't have that extra sauce. So that's why we're gonna throw on some Sapphire Glint to really make it catch the viewer's eye. Step one is gonna be coming underneath our layer, right clicking and hitting new adjustment layer. Once our adjustment layer has been created, we're gonna come up to effects and presets and type in glint. We're going to find this effect called S glint, click and drag it onto our adjustment layer. Depending on your clip, you may not see anything at first. However, if you play around with this threshold option here, you can start to see the glint impact the video. For this example, we only want the glint to impact the watch. We don't need it impacting all this other stuff here in the background. Come up to edit Mocha and click on this button. This is a tracking software that is going to help us track the watch so that the glint only impacts the watch and not the rest of the clip. When you open up Mocha, you want to make sure that you're in the classic workspace here so that you have all the available tools. The first step I'm going to take in Mocha is just coming back all the way to the very first frame. Now that we're here at the very beginning, I'm going to come up here to my X-spline layer tool, and I'm going to click on it and start to trace out this watch. So you can see all I'm doing is clicking around the watch area and it's creating the points for us. So this is going to tell Mocha that this is the object we want to track throughout this clip. You can see once we close off our tracing, we get this transform box that pops up. Come down here under our track options and we're going to click this one that says track forwards. Now as it tracks forwards, it's going to basically just follow our watch. Once it's done tracking, you can see as I scroll through, it locks on to the watch. I'm gonna come over here to my edge properties and set my edge properties up just a little bit, just to give us some more breathing room around the watch. From here, what I like to do is select motion blur, and then I'm going to come all the way up here to the top menu and click on this save the project button. Once you've done all that, we're going to close out of the Mocha tracker. Now you can see as we play with the threshold, it's only impacting the watch area. However, this still doesn't look great. So what we're going to do now is just customize the glint. Come up here to load preset. You can see down here, it opens up a bunch of presets for this plugin. However, you can't really see what's going on in a lot of them. So what I like to do, instead of previewing on the source, I will change this to preview on sample. And this gives me a much better understanding of the types of glints that we have at our disposal. What I like to do for these kind of jewelry clips is use this one called Realistic Glint 5. So we're just going to click on that and hit load. So we've applied the preset, but we can't really see it too well. So what I'm gonna do is just turn my threshold down until I can start to see the glint impact on the watch. And you can see that already looks really, really good. It looks a lot better than what we had before. In my opinion, the most important parameters to pay attention to are the brightness, which is going to be the brightness of the glint. And then we also have the size. So we can make our glints smaller or a lot larger, just like that. We also have blur. I usually keep the blur turned all the way down just because I really like the nice sharp edges coming off of the shine. Now under size, we also have this option called size details. And if we open this up, we can individually customize each one of these rays that's kind of coming off of the watch there. It's really customizable. I'm not gonna get too in detail with trying to customize these right now, just because I think this example already looks really good. So what we're going to do here at the beginning is start our threshold at a value closer to 1. So let's go 0.9 here at the very beginning, which pretty much eliminates all of the glint on the watch. We're going to make a keyframe at the very first frame. And then here, as the watch becomes kind of the center of attention, we're going to turn the threshold down. So as I turn the threshold down, you can see we start to get our effect working there. One thing I notice is it's very bright here on top of the watch. So what I can do is turn the brightness down a little bit and then bring the threshold down a little bit more just to kind of soften that up a little bit. It's really about balancing the values between the threshold and the brightness. I think those two work together really well. So now I'm just gonna come to the very last part of my timeline. Once the watch starts to kind of leave the frame, we're gonna bring our threshold back up to like a 0.8. So it kind of comes in and out of the brightness. As I scroll through here, you can see the watch gets brighter. Again, we keyframe those values. And then as it starts to kind of go back out of the frame, that brightness starts to end. All right, so here we go. It comes into focus, boom. You get that little glint that just shines off the watch. It looks like the sun rays are just beaming off the watch. It makes it look a lot cooler this way than just having, you know, a standard clip with the watch in it. I just think this effect is awesome. Anytime you have jewelry in your footage or anything that's kind of a shiny, noticeable object, definitely consider using S-Glint on that object. I do want to show you guys one more example today using this clip with a little bit more complex jewelry. So you can see we got some more shapes going on here in the jewelry. We're going to start it off the same way. We're going to right click underneath our layer and create an adjustment layer. Then on that adjustment layer, we're going to apply our S glint. We're going to come up here to edit mocha. We're going to open up our mocha tracker, come to the very first frame here. And this time we're going to use a different tool. We're going to use this magnetic pen tool here at the top menu instead of the X spline tool that we used in the first example. I prefer to use this magnetic tool for this example because this jewelry has a lot more details, especially around the edges. It's not just one shape throughout. It has a lot of curves and edges. The magnetic lasso slash pen tool built into Mocha is a much better option for us when tracing out, you know, more complex shapes like this piece of jewelry here. Once we've got it all traced out, just like the first example, we're going to track our jewelry. So that's what I'm going to do right now. I'm just going to click track forward and enable Mocha to do its thing. And now that the Mocha tracker is done, I'm just going to scroll through here. It looks good. It looks like it latches on really nicely to this jewelry piece. I'm gonna set our edge width a little bit bigger, and then I'm going to enable motion blur, come up to the save button, and then close out of Mocha. From here, I'm going to take our threshold blur down all the way so it's not blurry, and then I'm going to decrease the size of our glint. So you can see as we decrease the size, it starts to look a little bit better, a little bit more cohesive with the jewelry piece. So let's go ahead and come back here to the very first frame on our timeline, and let's start messing with the threshold and the brightness settings. So you can see there, it's just a little bit too bright at the top. I think we'll take the brightness down a little bit, but we'll take the threshold down as well. So it kind of has that shine to it here in the beginning. So again, I'm just gonna balance the brightness and the threshold. At this moment, what I'm gonna do is keyframe my brightness and my threshold values. We're gonna move about 1 second down into this timeline. Let's change these values. Let's decrease the brightness a little bit and increase the threshold so it doesn't have as much of a shine at this moment in time. Let's keep moving through this clip and seeing how this glint is appearing and then just making the adjustments we want. So if I increase the brightness and increase the threshold, what's gonna happen is you're gonna get less glint happening overall, but you're gonna have these more specific areas of the jewelry piece that start to get impacted. So if we decrease the threshold, we're gonna start impacting most of the jewelry piece. However, if we increase the threshold, we're going to impact less of the jewelry piece, and then we can customize the brightness of those little areas using the brightness value. So that's why I say play around with the brightness and the threshold, because you're gonna be able to get more detailed glints this way. Let's go like pretty much all the way to the end now of this clip, and let's take the brightness. Let's take the brightness down, and then let's decrease the threshold as well, so it starts to kind of get brighter again there towards the end. Not too much. We don't want it to look too fake. All right, so as our clip now plays back, it looks really, really cool. This is a really dope effect. I've really fallen in love with using the S-Glint plugin. Unfortunately, you can't find the S-Glint plugin built into After Effects. You're gonna have to go download the Sapphire suite, which I highly recommend checking it out. It has so many great plugins, and they've really helped me elevate my quality of work. Maybe you're not looking to spend any money at all to sauce up your next visual, and if that's the case, I highly recommend checking out my free pack on venturevisuals.com. We have samples from every pack on my website, including light leaks, overlays, title templates, and more. So if that sounds interesting to you, definitely check out the video editing shop link down below in the description. I really enjoyed creating this tutorial. I think the S-Glint plugin is so helpful and so cool, and I know you guys are gonna benefit from using it. If you have any questions about this plugin or any questions for me at all, please comment them down below underneath this video, or feel free to reach out to me directly on Instagram at @venturevisuals. I love when you guys send me your own work and ask me questions, so feel free to shoot me a message. I'm extremely grateful for you guys allowing me to continue to build this video editing community. It's such a blessing. I appreciate everyone for checking out my video today. Until next time, I'm Jake Venner. Peace out.